Hello and welcome to this presentation. My name is Oliver Blau and I'm CEO of the Westernacher Group. In this presentation, I will show you how you can validate your corporate carbon footprint. For that, I divided the presentation in three blocks. First block is about our initial situation when we started with that topic. Second block is about our first estimate that we felt we need to do at that time to bring first insights into that topics. And then we will discuss a little bit the validation process where we're in right now in order to really base our estimation on a good ground. So starting with the initial situation that we faced in 2021, at the very early days there, we at that time tried to write down our corporate social responsibility guideline. We did that in order to have a good document for upcoming questions with our partners. So could be our employees, could be our customers, potential customers, but also suppliers. Yeah. And therefore we again had that document sectioned into three sections, like ethics and compliance, social and people impact, and environmental and climate. While for the first two, we were pretty convinced and solid about the processes and what we should write down. Like take, for example, the ethics and compliance block. We knew that we are an ethical company. We are compliant with rules and regulations out there. Take, for example, anti-bribery. We are not in bribery when it comes to winning projects. And that's clear from the very beginning. We have processes to avoid. That's easy write down. Social and people impact is as easy for us to write down, or was as easy for us to write down, because as a consultancy company, you're anyway in a social and people business, and it's clear what you need to write down there. So take, for example, equal pay was never a topic for us. Women, men are paid equally. But when it came to the environmental and climate part, we felt, oops, that's a white spot here. We could probably have done much better in the past. And we decided at that point in time to really look more intensive into this topic. And we decided also to take a smaller topic out of there and look into our corporate carbon footprint. Doing so, if you would have asked somebody at that time in early 2021 what our carbon footprint is, I think most people would have come up with the answer, no idea. Is it 100 tons that we have yearly in emissions? Is it 1,000 tons, 100,000, a million? Nobody really knew. And that way, it was clear from the beginning, we need to create some transparency about our emissions first. Not that we need an exact number. That's of course not the case, in order to have first measures aligned that you can use to reduce your emissions. But at least a ballpark number, an idea of how big our emissions are. Yeah? Then you can use this number also with a little bit insights around this number, regional distribution, high hitters, and so on and so forth, in order to create first measures and then slowly bring down your carbon footprint in order at a certain point in time become carbon neutral. And this target for us was not like in the 2030s, 40s or 50s, but in the next some years, let's say 3 to 5 years. So doing so, creating some transparency was our first item that we needed to work on. We tried to have a first estimate, and doing that, you pretty much need to sit down and write down what are your business activities. And for us in the consulting industry, it's pretty much easy. Yeah, you have to basically your consultants working either from remote or from your offices, that in our case we have across the globe, or even working at premises of the customer in order, for example, to make some go lives happen very smoothly. But we were lucky to have all these business activities reported in our central SAP S/4HANA system. And this gave us at least the option to have all these business activity in one place, of course only the financial impact and not the related carbon footprint, but with that setup we could easily move all these business activities into our SAC Analytics Cloud and on the way calculate the related footprint of our business activities. So I give you one example. If I, for example, support a customer where I need to fly to, I basically buy a ticket and get the ticket price reimbursed after I have submitted the invoice for this flight to the central S4HANA system. Then I get it reimbursed, the financial impact is in the system. We need to transfer this ticket, this business activity to SAC Analytics Cloud, need to search a good emission factor for this flight, and then we have calculated the related footprint. Doing so, we were able to create a Westernacher carbon footprint monitor where we see several trends and have several findings. First of all, we had a timeline in there. So we started with that beginning from 2019, then had 2020 in there and 2021. So with that timeline, we could see that our footprint was decreasing over time due to the pandemic and the restrictions in travels that we had. Then also you see what the big hitters are there. For example, we saw that business travel is one of the most important sources for our emissions. And in this business travel, it's again the flights. Yeah. Then we saw also a regional distribution of our emissions that I show you on the next slide. Take, for example, the dark blue point in the middle, that's Germany, where we have a big team and we basically offer all the SAP services that we offer to our clients. Yeah? And with those big teams and the many services we offer, we have a lot of business activities there and, of course, a resulting high carbon footprint in Germany. If you take now the Indian team, which is even bigger than our German team, but has less travel, you still end up with a high number for your carbon footprint because the team is pretty big there. And then if you go to China on the one hand side and US on the other hand side, you see a different trend. We there have also big teams, but not as big as in India or in Germany. But the distances in these countries are quite heavy. So in order to visit a customer, you basically need to take a flight. But as flights are related with a high carbon footprint for each flight, the countries produce, or the colleagues there produce, relatively high emissions. Yeah, doing that, we in the end came to a result of an approximation of 1,200 metric tons of carbon emitted in 2021 for the whole consulting division. But with that result in mind, what can you do with those with this number? You can of course say, okay, I care about good measures to reduce this footprint, but you have basically no idea if this is a good value or a bad value. If others do better, if you should perform better, no idea. So at that point in time, we said, basically, it's important to validate this number and also base it on a common ground to be comparable to other companies. So the idea was to really invite somebody from the outside world, so engage an advisor who can discuss main topics around there and help us validate numbers. We thought this is a good idea, mainly out of five reasons. First of all, we were pretty much convinced that we had the big emission sources in our calculation. Yeah, the flights, the other transportation modes, the offices, and so on and so forth. Yeah, but we were not so sure that we had really a complete picture. Yeah, and in the end, we found out that we have been missing some things. Yeah, like the air conditioning, for example, also produces a carbon footprint, and we did not have that on the agenda, like several smaller others emissions as well. So completeness is something that we tried to gain in cooperation with a independent advisor from outside. And also it's important to have your calculations validated in a sense if the calculations are correct. Basically, you can find a lot of emission factors, but they are emission factors with very, very high deviations. And if an emission factor has such a high deviation, it's probably not the best emission factor you can find. That's important to discuss with somebody. But then also, if you convert the grams to the kilograms and the tons of carbon, there's always a factor of 1,000 in between, and that can destroy your complete calculation if you do a mistake there. So if in the end you have calculated your emissions like we did with the 1,200 tons for the whole company, it's somehow also important to gain comparability with other companies. Are we good? Are we bad? Could we do much better? Yeah, these are the questions that you can only answer if you are comparable to others. That means you need to calculate based on a common ground, so with reference to a certain standard. And that was also something we want to discuss with an advisor. And then in the end, if you have calculated, if you are complete, if you are correct, if your values are comparable, you're going to also publish your results. And when publishing, it gives you better credibility when somebody from outside says, yes, it's okay what they're doing at Westernacher when calculating their footprint. So we engaged an advisor, that's advice for you. If you want to go in this business and look for your footprint, then do that from the very beginning. Because these people are usually maxed out right now because you're not the only company looking for an advisor. And therefore, we as Westernacher lost 3 months in the whole process just to search for an appropriate advisor. So please do that very well in advance. But the first thing we discussed with our advisor when we finally found one was which should be the standard that we are following. Yeah, and it was pretty clear from the very first discussions that we will be following greenhouse gas protocol, just because, as the most important reason, greenhouse gas protocol is so widely used out there, also from other companies. So if you look in the internet for publications and you find publications from prominent other companies, you will mostly see that they refer to greenhouse gas protocol. And that gives you a good feeling, because then you are really comparable to others and your numbers have a certain meaning. If you work with greenhouse gas protocol, you basically need to group your emissions in three scopes. Scopes are like baskets where you gather the emissions that belong together. Scope 1 in greenhouse gas protocol is the direct emissions. And these are all the emissions that you basically have produced yourself in your own premises or in your own assets. Own assets could be a company car, not an electric, of course, but a conventional company car, but could also be your heating, for example, your offices, and then that's also a direct emission that needs to be counted here under scope 1. Greenhouse gas protocol knows scope 2 as well. Those are the indirect emissions coming, for example, from your purchased electricity. Usually, this electricity is produced somewhere in a power plant, transported via network to your premises where you use it. And when using, the usage is decoupled mainly from the production, but still you're responsible for this emission. And then in scope 3, basically there is all the rest. Mainly it's a big basket, because you have your products in there that need to be counted. I mean, we as a consulting company have their value of 0 because we don't have products, but usually as a manufacturer of goods, for example, you have to care about the emissions produced when sourcing raw materials, when constructing your products, when the usage is also counted in here, but also end of life cycle treatment and transportation. So pretty much everything around your products counts in scope 3. And then also the business activities that you need to do in order to get these products on the road is also something you need to count here in the upstream section. That means business activities like employee commute, could also be the business travel where we have high values, but is also purchased goods and services. Purchased service, for example, in our case, we have a big landscape, demo landscape of SAP topics that we can demo to our potential customers. And this needs to be counted in here as a purchased service, for example. So what we did next was, and remember the 1,200 tons that we had as a ballpark number for our carbon footprint. We now try to apply the greenhouse gas protocol for one of these units out of the initial calculation. This was the UK unit, and there we calculated in our initial calculation 48 tons, but there was a buffer in there for things we did not know at that time and for things we left out, and therefore we had calculated a buffer and had a first estimate of 48 tons for this Westernacher UK unit. We repeated now the calculation based on greenhouse gas protocol, found out that we have 3 tons of emission in scope 1. In scope 2, we had also 3 tons of emission, and all the rest, 38 tons, we had in scope 3, which is mainly our business travel. Yeah? And with that, in total, we had 44 tons compared to the 48 tons of our initial estimation. Good value, we are close to that. And that makes us pretty confident that in the end we will be somewhere at the around 1,200 tons that we initially calculated for the whole group. So now we are in the process of really calculating all the Westernacher companies around the world, calculating their footprints based on GHG protocol. While doing that, and we hope to finish that exercise end of March, beginning of April, while we're doing that, we started a second initiative to also make sure to really remove the carbon that we have blown into the atmosphere in 2021, remember the 1,200 tons, remove those from the atmosphere by supporting good projects. In our case, that's a reforestation project. Yeah, and so doing that, we are carbon neutral as of 2021. But now the challenge starts with the next years, where we still will try to improve our business and grow in revenue people, which means we will have more business activities, while greenhouse gas protocol requests us to have lower emissions, not in relative numbers, but in absolute numbers. So we need to come down from the 1,200 tons to maybe 1,000 tons in the next years, although we at the same time try to improve our business on the other hand side. Yeah, this will be an ongoing challenge, not only for us, but also for all other companies trying to improve their footprint while improving their business as well. With that said, I'm at the end of my presentation. Thanks for your participation, and I'm happy to open now the Q&A session. Thank you.